signs of inflammation. What are the signs?
Redness,
pain, rumor, color, dolor, rumor, and tumor. All the four should be there. There will be redness, there will be swelling, there will be pain, there will be heat. So, the first sign of inflammation on the skin will be belladonna. Belladonna means red, congested, throbbing pain. That's the first. After the belladonna stage is over, then there is a sensitivity. Mind you, the pus has not been formed. But the pus is going to be formed. Pus has not been formed. But the pus is going to be formed. When that situation comes, that area becomes further more sensitive. Basically, belladonna is a sensitive case, but when the belladonna case becomes further more sensitive, that means you cannot even touch it. Cannot touch that particular thing, cannot examine. The most important remedy, if no one like permits you to touch even normal skin.
Arnica.
Correct. Arnica. Arnica will not let you touch even take it to a patient. The body is so sore to touch. Remember, a general and a particular. As an example, Brahminia. I'm sure I have my mind the example Brahminia because everybody has to know. Brahminia's modality is aggravation by move. That everybody knows. Now I have got inflammation of this joint. I have got inflammation of this joint. If I move like this and the pain starts, it is bad. Am I right? You are right. The movement aggravates. But if I move my eyelids like this and the pain comes here, then still it is bad. If I move my eyelids here, the pain is here. Still it is Brahminia. If I move here, the pain is there. It is Brahminia. Mind you, these two Brahminias have to be understood. The first Brahminia was Brahminia as a particular. That Brahminia is a particular. This Brahminia is a generality. So pain by the movement at distant places becomes a general. Similarly, arnica will not permit you to take the blood pressure because she or he has got the sensation of sore body pain. That is generality. One single symptom is enough for you to select the entire remedy. If there is injury and there is laceration, there is pain, there is a soreness, burning, it is arnica as a particular. Then this arnica becomes a particular. Have I been able to make myself clear? Have you understood? Good. Hippocamp. Hippocamp is a remedy which comes after belladonna, where the pus has not formed. It is started to form. So, it is a separative remedy in the first stage. Here, the sensitivity is too much. So much so, the patient doesn't permit you to touch. That is the person. Pricking pain, chapped skin, sensitive to even contact. You cannot even touch it. Keri Ayog has got boils, which is after the person. Mind you, before the pus is formed, the sensitivity is too much. Gradually, when the pus has developed, the sensitivity reduces. When the abscess has been formed, the sensitivity is totally reduced. So when you come to silicia stage, when the abscess is there, the sensitivity reduces, only a sensation of bursting will be there. That means now, that pustule, that abscess is going to burst. But then you can palpate the abscess. Silicia abscess can be palpated. Hippocamp abscess cannot be touched. These are the pustules. Now, silentia. Silentia is induration. Most important sign for silentia, if at all it has to prescribe, only by seeing pursued are two. One, there will be induration round the pustule. You see this black thing? This is indurated. That means that area is thick. That means infiltration of the polymorphonuclear lymphocytes are there. And the pus. So you will see here and here both of these pustules, the induration is seen. These are the indurated areas. Depulsion. Now this is a chickenpox case which has become suppurative. All the vesicles have become pustules. These vesicles should have become pustules. And you see in erythema, one of the very important thing is that here you see induration and here you see erythema. Erythema around the pustule is sulfur. That means this has not been completely suppurated. Small quantum of inflammation has still remained. That is sulfur. Thanks. Now, abscess. Inflammation means redness, congestion, belladonna. Sensitivity, pus formations to start with is repulsor, carry out silentia, and silentia is abscess formation, where the pus has completely developed. When the pus completely develops, it is an abscess. The pustule is small than 1 centimeter or 2 centimeters. If it is bigger than that, it is an abscess. The abscess has to be built. Yes, either it will burst open. Silentia is one of the remedies. Silentia is one of the remedies in allopathic America. This is open surgery. One of the surgeries, surgical medicines what we have got is one silentia. Silentia can throw away any foreign matter which is there in the body. इसीलिए suppose you put dental appliance लगा हुआ हो और for that matter कोई obstetric or orthopedic appliance लगाई हुई हो, in such person you prevent yourself as far as possible to give such remedies like silentia, because silentia is one of the remedies which throws away the foreign body. वो यहाँ वहाँ पस तैयार करेगा, पस तैयार करके पूरा ये करेगा, लेकिन थ्रो अवे मेक ए फिस्टुला एंड थ्रो अवे द फॉर्म वन डेट सो इट्स अ वेरी कॉमन थिंग यू मस्ट हैव अंडरस्टूड जो एपिलेप्टिक पेशेंट बेड पे रहे देन व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट द ब्लड सप्लाई टू दैट पोर्शन ऑफ द स्किन इज रिड्यूस्ड द हाइजीनिक स्टेट इज ऑल्सो नॉट गुड परस्पिरेशन इज देयर favoring multiplication of the microorganisms over there, and so you produce SO. This is known as SO. SO is an ulcer. A colloquial term for ulcer is SO. So bed sore is SO, it's an ulcer. After the pus or abscess has bursted away, so from belladonna to silentia, from silentia you come to mouth sore. Mud salt is for ulcers. So a bed sore is an ulceration. You see the opening over there? That is because the patient was lying on a particular area where the blood supply stopped. Next. Now, gangrene. Now, this is the most dangerous thing. Gangrene, there are two major types of gangrene. One is this gangrene, which is known as a dry gangrene. This gangrene, you see the toes, the toe, and even the great toe, there is a lack of blood supply to them. Now this is known as a Raynaud's phenomena. In Raynaud's phenomena, the patient is very sensitive to cold. So he or she, if he goes to cold, or in a very cold climate, or in a very cold place, suddenly there is a massive pressure constriction. and because of vasoconstriction, the blood supply to the distal portion in the body is reduced or rather stopped, and the most distal portion is the toe. So the great toe, small toes, the blood supply to those toes reduces, and the moment the blood supply is stopped, then ischemia. And if there is ischemia, the tissues start dying. That is known as necrosis. So there is a necrotic phenomenon starting. And to that necrotic, we say as gangrene. So gangrene is a result of necrosis due to ischemia as a result of massive cold exposure. That is known as the dry gangrene. The commonest remedy which we use for dry gangrene is
Cicalcor.
Cicalcor is one of the very, very common remedies, and I am sure those who must have got these cases of dry gangrene, they all will be able to contribute their experiences, and really Cicalcor acts marvelous. Yes, we cannot do anything for this toe. We cannot do anything. Because once it is dead, it is dead. So that toe will be shed off. But definitely we can prevent further development of the gangrene. That one. The second gangrene is a wet gangrene. And wet gangrene is not because of this, it is because of the organism. And the organism known is
Clostridium
welchii. Clostridium welchii is an organism which produces wet gangrene. When it infects the organ, it produces a necrotic material and produces H2S, very offensive gas. You cannot if there is a wet gangrene here, if you press here, the gas will come out. Clostridium welchii, in the environment of carbohydrate, produces H2S, and H2S is liberated. And entire area is swollen. So press the bone, and that is wet gangrene. Very bad gangrene, very dangerous gangrene, and the gangrene usually is a constitutional disorder. It is going to kill the patient. Here the patient not going to be killed. Here the patient not going to die. He will only lose a particular organ. But that is a constitution. Now coming back to the secondary lesions. We are talking about the primary lesions. Now secondly, the primary lesions means, mind you, they are the lesions of the disease per se. Secondary lesions are the lesions after the disease is over. Scales. You know, when you psoriasis patient, they have you see psoriasis. Have you seen a case of psoriasis? So, okay, now you come in to see the medical case. In psoriasis, you see, normally psoriasis is a disease, which is a scaly disease. This disease is fully covered, so bruise nikalti hai. That is, you are must aware of the dandruff, na? Actually, everybody is using shampoo. So, it is one extension of dandruff. So this is the disease which is an extension of dandruff. Dandruff, in our medical term, we say seborrhea.